this out. Stop, stop, stop.
Oh, he's getting owned. He is getting owned.
Double hookups.
Now, when you're heading out fishing, it's always going to improve your chances if you get up early in the morning. But when you get up early in the morning, your boat's already in the water, your live bait tank's already full of live baits, and you're starting from Kingfish Lodge right on some of the best fishing in the entire country, it's probably about as good a start to the day as you're going to get. That's gone good for me, that Orca stick bait. With me today, I've got Adam Alagiers along and a special guest angler, Jamie McDowell. Famous for her singing and songwriting, but not so well known is that she loves her fishing. And she'll be getting a crack at a kingfish much sooner than any of us expected.
There's kingies busting up over there, look. Over there, Adam, there's kingies busting up. There's kingies busting up on the surface over there. Oh, there he is.
Oh yeah.
Well, here we go. I haven't even managed to get a live bait out. Adam's just gone up the front and done a cast, and we can see kingfish smashing up on the surface here. Kind of, did I say that the start couldn't get much better? Well, it could. Oh, there he goes, he's just hooked up. Yeah, he's got him, on. Got him on. There we go. Oh, yeah. Look at that, coming up, trying to get a live bait rigged up. Oh, look, there's kingies there. Adam cast, boom, we hook up. Great start to the day. Okie dokie, just gonna try and slip this little lip gaff, beautiful little top shot lip gaff into his mouth so it doesn't harm him too much. Now this is a Orca stick bait and I've had great success with that particular one. So there you go. Always nice to start your day with a nice wee fish like that. And this one here's going home and then we're gonna go and see some more of his mates. Okay, let's go again now guys. Out goes our live bait. Adam's going to be up the front casting and we can have a race to see who's going to hook up first. Jamie on the live bait or Adam on the stick bait?
Got to be prepared for this.
Oh yeah, fish.
Alright, here we are. Look, right on the stick bait now. Yep. Oh, he's already hooked up.
Go,
you greedy bugger. I said when we come here we're going to be trying to catch Jamie a kingfish.
Yeah.
Whoa, taking a bit of light.
Scream, Stella.
I'm just backing the boat away from the rocks because we were in only 8 metres of water when Adam hooked up, but Adam's got the Stella and he's just cranked the drag up. He's just dragging that kingie out of here. Nice little fatty. He's going home. There you go, he's powered away. Beautiful, well done. Now can I do some fishing? Well, given we were sort of rudely interrupted by those kingfish, it would probably be equally as rude for us not to try and get our mate Jamie hooked up to one. So we're just gonna run you with a live bait, Jamie. And we're gonna fish in free spool. I'll put that clicker on, okay? It'll stop an overrun. And I'm just gonna idle slowly around. We're gonna tow that live bait behind us. All yours.
This is gonna be good value, eh? She hooks up. Never caught a kingie before. It's gonna get dealt to.
Get a little bit more out. Oh, there you go. It's been bitten. No. Just push the drag. Look, he wants a bit. Wind. That didn't take. How long did that take?
Give it.
He's a hot one. Going the way we want it to go. Just keep winding nice and smooth.
Come on, muscles.
Okay, well, so how's this working out for you?
Great.
So I didn't really have a chance to give you the full demonstration. We hooked up a lot too soon. We're still actually just getting set up, getting organised. Okay, what gear are we going to use today, guys? Getting some cameras ready. And next thing you know, there's a whole bunch of kingies smashing up on the surface. And what, we're hooked up to our third one. Wow. Oh, I had this whole intro thing that I was going to do with you, Jamie, saying this weekend on the ITM Fishing Show, we're
fishing with the talented young singer-songwriter Jamie McDowell. But I kind of didn't get to that, so maybe we could just use that bit there. Hi guys, this is Jamie. She's hooked up to a kingfish. Okay, just keep winding, keep winding. Oh, there we go, stop there, stop winding there. Oh, textbook. Hooked in the corner of the mouth. Now what do we do, Jamie?
I'll just jump on it.
You've been watching too much TV. Okay, there is your fish.
Hold it.
Of course you can hold it. Okay, now you're going to get covered in slime, but it's so worth it. Underneath here, here we go. Okay, now just while we're getting ready for our photos, Jamie, I'm just going to run through this because our viewers are going to want to know exactly what we did here. We used a Jack Mackerel live bait. Oh,
got him.
Okay, and we've used a VMC circle hook. I've just used a rubber band to attach the live bait. Snelled onto some 100-pound Suffolk fluorocarbon leader, and that's all the important information. And right now we can. Hang on, I'll roll it over so we can see the fish. Hang on, you're going to get slimy, but it's so
it's
worth
right.
it. There we go. Okay, bust out those pictures. Okay, we've got our photos. There we go. That is a nice warm-up sort of size fish for you, there, Jamie.
It's actually the biggest kingfish I've ever caught.
Okay, you're in for a big day then. Okay, now just head first, turn around, and just slide them nicely into the water. Nice job. Hey, all right. That's a wrap. Literally, we're not set up yet this morning. Sun's still coming up. Didn't I say something in my intro? I've forgotten all that. Seems like so long ago now, about being up early in the morning, having a tank full of live baits, and being at Kingfish Lodge. Well, we've barely got out of Kingfish Lodge, and we're three kingies on the board. That was almost a high five moment there, boom. But we'll get that chemistry going. That'll come. The chemistry will come later in the day, Jamie.
Sure will, yep.
Oh, he's getting owned. He is getting owned. Double hooked up. Check this out. Stop. Oh. Hey. Well, I hope you're enjoying this classic episode. But if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips, and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app. Available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv. And that there is your classic single hook pulley rig. Some of those darker marks on the top of that bait there look like they're predators. And the predators that we're after are kingfish. Big kingfish. You ready? We're right on some right now. Yep, there, kingies right there. Only about 40 metres down. Go. Well, we're a little bit more organised now. We've managed to clean up the cockpit, get some rods put away, get the outriggers up, get some sunblock on, and we're ready to start our day's fishing. And, we're actually carrying on just the way that we started before, with Adam fishing a lure. However, he's not fishing a lure on the surface in the form of a stick bait anymore. That's because we're in 70 metres of water. He's got a jig, vertical jigging, dropping it down to some sign that I've marked on the Furuno there. And Jamie's doing exactly the same thing, fishing with a live bait. However, this time there's a sinker on the live bait, dropping it down to where the fish are.
Oh, yep.
Oh, yeah. Adam a moment ago was complaining about that big 400 gram jig that I got him to be cranking in. Said, big jig, big kingfish. He's got it on 80 pound gear there. And what you just witnessed is I spotted those fish and they're still on our screen on the TZ Touch in there. And I said, Adam, 40 meters. Got rainbow braid there, it's colored. Put out four colors, 10 meters per color, that's how it works. And he's hooked up. If that all sounded complicated, don't worry, we'll show you again soon. Right on top of the rock, eh? And there's a little bit more sign there now too. There you go. Look at that. Look at that clear. Oh, it's not a bad one, you know. That's not a bad one, you know. That 80 pound line just dominated him in that Oshia jigger. Look, he's just eating that jig. He's eating it. Holy crap, look at that for a fish, boy. Okay, come on. Get ready.
Yep.
Nah, I'm holding. Okay. I'm gonna let go.
Yep.
Okay, we'll just let him calm down. I'll clean my specs and we might start again.
You just got him in so quick on that gear, you dominated him. That's a nice fish, bro. Once again, you've snaked Jamie's fish. Okay, we got a stills camera ready. You know, you want to go photographer for us, Jamie? Okie doke. Let's have another go. Hopefully a little bit more tight. Keep winding, mate. Dominated him. How much drag is on that thing? Okay, Adam, if you put the rod in the rod holder,
yeah.
I'm going to swing him straight into your arms, ready for a photo. Okay, hang on, you ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, go! Straight in there. This is how we got the system down. Oh, we better get one photo with that jig. There you go.
400 grams.
Oh,
I was complaining about it before.
That's a nice one, boy. That's over 20 kilo. Don't you worry about that.
Woohoo.
That is a look at the depth of the body on that fish. Oh, well, that's another kingfish for Adam. All on lures, and they're not eating the live baits at the moment. So when fish aren't feeding sometimes, you can entice a bite by using a lure. Okay. Mean, bro. Okay, do we have a volunteer for active duty? Oh, nice big bait. Well, I figure I've done enough of being skipper and deckhand, and I might just chuck a bait out myself. Oh.
Felt like a snapper whacked it then.
Yeah, it's trying to eat it. Whatever it is. Snapper trying to eat my kingy live bait. Yo, oh, dropped them. Still, look at that. I mean, they must have eaten that live bait off by now. I reckon they're just attacking the sinker. I've had that before. They get fired up on the live bait, they eat the live bait, and the snapper will actually, you know, get into a feeding frenzy and they'll attack the sinker. Oh, there you go, there's another little whack. They're biting the sinker. Well, there you go. The bait's been eaten off. Oh yeah, and look at that. Bites all over that sinker. They are just voracious once they get feeding. However, it's not snapper we're after, it's kingfish. Gotta stay on task. Okay, guys. Gonna go live bait again, Jamie. Get on that 400 gram jig, bro.
I don't know what I'll do.
Oh, yep.
There you go. Oh, he's getting owned.
He is getting owned.
Definitely a bit bigger than the other one. Maximum
drag.
You
all right if I go forward a little bit?
Yeah, possibly, yeah.
Trying to keep Jamie's line down there. As soon as you seem to be hogging all the action there.
This third time,
actually. Oh, yeah. Chivalry is well and truly dead on this boat. Oh, yeah, I've been bit. Okay, it's all yours. Get amongst it.
Oh.
Oh,
okay,
oh,
guys.
Hard. Okie doke. Well done, team. Double hookups.
Well done, I'm so bad.
It's a roundabout now. We've got a few thank yous to make. Thank you to the Pink and Lumo Benthos jig. Thank you to the Suffolk's line, the Oshia jigger, to the kingfish, to the live bait, and to the Furuno that put us right on these pumpers. Tough fighting fish, eh?
Okay.
Are you ready, mate? Then grab them off me. Ready?
Yeah.
Look at that.
Get him!
I like that system.
Yeah. Okay, you ready?
Okay. 18 kilo, maybe? Oh, less.
After your last one, there's no much point to get a real photo.
Yeah.
Let him rip, mate. What have we got here? It's another. Yeah. Check this out! Stop!
Hey!
Look, we said we needed something for the table, didn't we? And what have you gone and done and caught us a beautiful snapper?
Oh yeah!
That's the way to put a feed on the table, girl. Good on, I was saying, look, there might be some snapper hassling those live baits, and that's exactly what we have got. We're going to eat so well tonight. What's your biggest snapper?
this one.
Oh, the ITM fishing show where dreams come true.
Lots of firsts.
So you've just gone from singer-songwriter to fish model.
Awesome.
Straight away, Jamie. And look right there on the sounder, right under the boat.
It's going to most likely another one of our snapper mates.
South rig, south hooks.
Now she's bringing it home.
What have we got going on? Another snapper. She's killing it. Brilliant, and they're just beautiful eating fish too.
Yeah, get in there.
Get in there, own it.
You got him.
And there she goes again, the provider.
I don't know, I don't want to say it too many times. It's just when we're seeing fish, when they're in the right places and we're getting the right sort of marks, or by the right sort of marks, like definite dark marks, there are predators around the bait schools we're hooking up.
There you go, nice. The snapper pro. Swing it on in. Yes, that is awesome. A nice eating snapper. That's a real nice eating snap, and not only are you going to feed us tonight, you're going to make about 75% of our audience very happy. Well done, look at that. There you go, there's that circle hook. That started off as a live bait. You can see the remnants there, which is the rubber band, which is how I like to attach my baits. And that snap has just come along and chomped it.
Yep.
Well, I figure I've been skipper and deckhand long enough. I'm gonna drop down my well beaten up bottom ship jig and hope that I don't hook a kingfish hook. Yep. Uh-oh. I don't think this is a snapper. Goodbye, my favourite old bottom ship too. There's not a lot I can do here. Uh-oh. Dang it! I've had this lure for ages, I've caught so many snapper on it. I was encouraged by Jamie catching those snapper that I thought, well, I'll drop a bottom ship over, it'd be nice to catch a snapper, and I've gone and hooked a kingfish that is just far too big for 20 pound trace. Oh, there we go, lost him. Well, I think I kept my lure. Hey!
Never been so happy to lose a kingfish.
Okay guys, I think we've had a pretty fair crack at it today, so let's not leave it all out on the paddock right now. We'll go back to Kingfish Lodge and with the snapper that Jamie's provided, maybe the chef could whip something up and we'll come back out tomorrow, because right now I've got a cold beverage calling my name. Back at the lodge.
We get some fantastic weather and set out to really put Jamie to the test with some big fish. And without giving too much away, the kingfish are biting and they're even bigger. So we mix it up and go for some variety and try and show Jamie just what fishing up here in Northland is all about.
Oh, on the left! On the left, Marlon! Now, if you're gonna be fishing with these Orca stick baits, and let's face it, why wouldn't you? A couple of other bits of kit that you're gonna need. You're gonna need some of these pliers. These are just Shimano heavy-duty pliers. And you're gonna need one of these beautiful little lip gaffs, just so you can pop it through their lip. And that way, you can hold on them securely. You can just pop that in their mouth. Release them unharmed if you want to release them, or bring them in and kill them if you want to eat them. So here's all the equipment you need right here. The stick bait, the Top Shop lip gaff, and the Shimano pliers. And it also helps if you flatten your barbs down as well. We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.